Hi everyone, my name is Arvin Olano and welcome to my YouTube channel. So, nobody asked, but in today's video, I want to talk to you about some luxury master bedroom designs from some of my favorite interior designers. We're going to pick it apart, dissect it, see what works and what doesn't, and hopefully you can learn a little something to make your own master bedroom a little more luxurious. Now, I will say, the one thing that all of these bedrooms have in common is the heavy focus on natural materials. Think linens, crisp cotton percales, and even silk. So, this portion of the video is in partnership with Lily Silk, and they have the most incredible silk product, you guys. Silk bedding, pillowcases, and pajamas. Just look at this like silk piping detail. It's so, so luxurious. I also want to show you their silk pillowcases. I got it in the classic white. It has a really beautiful logo detail. This is a classic piece to have in your bedroom, you guys. And when I'm telling you, this is like, I've never actually tried silk pillowcases before. And these last few days have been so, so luxurious. Sleeping with silk pillowcases have a ton of benefits. It's so good for your skin. It's antibacterial. Not only that, but it actually helps with the wrinkles. When you're sleeping on a pillow for so many hours, like your skin can get all like wonky, you know? And silk definitely helps with that issue. Lily Silk has a ton of different products, from beautiful pajama sets, robes, silk bedding. They even have silk masks, okay? This is a must-have for everybody. This is so luxe. Not only does it look so high-end, you can breathe. So if you're interested in checking out Lily Silk, make sure you go ahead and click that link down below in the description box. Use my code ARVIN12 for a discount. All right, let's jump straight into the first master bedroom design, and this one is Jen Atkin's master bedroom. This bedroom is actually designed by Erick Garcia of Maison Trouville, and whew, when I'm telling you, I feel so peaceful, calm, ready to go to sleep. When I see this bedroom design, I feel like the star of this bedroom are these pacha lounge chairs from Gubi. They are spectacular. You guys know I love a good curvy, low bedroom moment. And having that seating area in front of your bed is key. Having that little seating area is good to put like your bag at the end of the day, or you can just relax and read a book. I'm loving the use of sheer curtains in this space, and notice how it's all the way up into the ceiling. That's a great way to make your spaces look even larger. And notice all the little pleats in the curtain. It's sheer, so it's letting light filter in really beautifully. Those pleats just add an unexpected textural element to a very neutral space. Looking at the actual bed itself, I'm seeing a very low headboard. This is a very popular look at the moment. It looks very minimal and clean, and I actually really enjoy that there's only her main pillows on the bed. There's no clutter. It's very, very simple, and the duvet is just like casually draping over the edge, giving that relaxed vibe. Now, I almost kind of wish that there was something above the bed just to kind of complete this space, but I'm sure this was all intentional and really wanted to do a minimal aesthetic. This luxury bedroom definitely says less is more, and when you do it right, minimalism can look really, really nice. Just like this bedroom. Okay, so this next bedroom is so, so nice. It's by Amber Lewis of Amber Interiors, and whew, you guys, Amber Lewis is a master at creating a cozy, like vintage rustic space. And I remember when I first saw this, I just thought like, woo, wow. I mean, look at the way she mixes all of these vintage textiles, the prints, the color, to create a warm and inviting bedroom. I specifically love this Kilim bench at the foot of her bed. This is something that a lot of these bedrooms have, is an additional seating arrangement. And this not only helps fill the space, but again, it gives you another area to relax, get comfortable. I also really love how she uses trays. Is that a crystal? Ooh, I see a little crystal on top of the tray and some fresh flowers, which is always a plus. Again, let's take a look at these curtains that are reaching for the ceiling. I've actually kind of done that here in my studio to kind of create like this faux window effect for my backdrops. Let's take a look at the mix of the wood tones here. This accent chair on the right has a beautiful, like dark, almost walnut color. And her doors are more of like a mid-tone brown. And then the tray has more of a chocolate brown wood. I love when I see spaces with that kind of mix and match wood elements, because to me it feels designed, it feels high end. You can also see that there's a lot of high contrast in this space. There's a black nightstand, a dark pillow against a light chair, and then the rug that really grounds the space. Wow, I feel like Amber Lewis can like do no wrong. I'm seeing so many different tonalities and different colored neutrals now that I'm really looking at this space. This is just what makes me happy about like design, is like you can have fun, you can play around, nothing has to be like matchy-matchy, okay? We don't want that anymore. That is so dated, like no personality whatsoever. If you need some master bedroom design inspo, go check out Amber Interiors. Okay, so this next bedroom design, we're actually gonna look at a couple because they are from Restoration Hardware. Now, I know I just roasted matchy-matchy designs in the last bedroom, and I feel like Restoration Hardware, their showrooms and their catalogs are all about like a matching set, you know? But I do feel like we can learn something from their designs. This first photo has the infamous cloud bed with warm colored nightstands. Now, good contrast. Behind the lamps, you actually have this really tall rectangular mirror that reaches for the ceiling. And this is a nightstand styling moment that I particularly love here in my home. I actually have like more of an irregular mirror for my bedroom, but this kind of styling really allows light to bounce back and forth really beautifully in a bedroom. You can see in this reflection, there is a window. I also really love that huge art piece above the bed. This is something that I wish was in Jen Atkin's bedroom, like a big piece of art. So the mirrors, the art piece, the nightstands really help to create a focal wall in your bedroom. You wanna walk in and really kind of like, whoa, there's your bed, right? This design is making you want to look at the wall where the bed is. And the layering of the pillows is something that we can take note of as well. You have the large king loungers and then two other pillows that are a little bit smaller. Those different sizes help to create a variety and depth in a bedroom pillow moment. Here is another bedroom design from Restoration Hardware with that same mirrored nightstand styling. Now, I feel like this one is kind of a miss. The headboard is way too high, and there's this awkward like cutoff point when you're looking at this photo. I almost wish the mirror was the same height as the headboard. So when you're designing your own space, you wanna think about those elements, like where things stop and where things end. You really want them to be uniform, especially if you're talking about your focal wall. Or they could have added maybe a few art pieces above the bed. Okay, comment down below if you would add mirrors like this to your nightstand bedroom moment as well. So this next bedroom is another one of my favorites. I've saved it time and time again, every time I see it on social media, and it is this master bedroom by Studio Mcgee. I want to actually start with her rug placement. This is so smart because it's kind of like halfway into the bed and it's grounding that space. The rug really helps to draw your eyes into the main part of the room, right? Which is where the bed is. Really going back to that focal point idea. Her bed frame is this delicious, like, olive grayish color. And the way she layered her textiles, she is a master at layering her pillows. I love the toile de joie vintage pillows with the long lumbar, the duvet just casually folded. And my favorite thing about this bedroom is actually this massive bench at the foot of the bed. I remember Shae said that this is actually more of like a day bed. It's so stunning. I love that warm kind of mid-tone brown wood and the leather accents down below. I also really appreciate her dark nightstand. I feel like that's something that we're gonna be seeing a lot this year. At the corner of the bedroom, you have a really cozy chair, a big pillow, and this dark brown stool. Talk about a delicious contrasting color, but still keeping it neutral. You guys, like, when it's a neutral color palette, it just feels so much more high-end. And not only that, it's like, it really helps you go to sleep. I mean, I wouldn't want to sleep in a bedroom that's all like blue and red and just, it would drive me insane. Obviously, all the pieces in this bedroom were probably super custom, really expensive. What's so great about the Studio Mcgee design is you can easily replicate it in your own home, which brings me to my next point. You don't have to buy the most expensive pieces to have a luxurious bedroom. It's all about thoughtful execution, space planning, and choosing the right materials and right fabrics. All right, we made it to the last luxury bedroom design, and it is Athena Calderone's Amagansett Master Bedroom. Whew! I had to talk about this bedroom because this is art, like literal art. I really enjoy the way that Athena uses different shapes and forms to create visual interest in her designs. Look at that wavy vintage Italian chair, the triangular lampshade, the round vintage pillows. I mean, there is just something for your eyes to land upon in every little corner that you look at. It's so thoughtfully designed. When I read her post about her bedroom and she talked about asymmetry, she has this beautiful drum side table from Apparatus, and at the other side is, I believe, a travertine piece. And look at these sconces with like the bamboo details and the art piece just over to the right. Athena is just a design genius. We can all agree on that. And of course, you have that rug placement. She's really playing with warm, neutral tones here in this space. I love that graphic print of the rug. It really just like pops on the floor, you know what I mean? Don't even get me started on the curtains anymore, because by now you would know you need to hang it all the way up the ceiling, honey. Look at that, it's literally touching the ceiling. I will say, these two little stools at the front, that is quite interesting. I'm almost certain those are either antique or vintage. You guys know Athena plays with so much vintage elements. Look at that burl wood pedestal with the sculpture. I mean, this is just such an artistic view on a master bedroom. No wonder it was featured on Architectural Digest, okay? I feel like we can all learn something from Athena in creating a very special and unique space. Out of all of the bedrooms that we talked about today, this is the most, like, hands-down unique bedroom, okay? All right, everyone, that was it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure you sound off in the comments down below and let me know your favorite bedroom design. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, everyone.